Welcome to yet another video tutorial of testing advices. In previous video, we have learned about Maven setup, and in this video, we will learn Eclipse setup. To know more about Eclipse workspace packages, please refer the blog and write to us if any queries. So let's start with Eclipse setup. Launch the browser and Google Eclipse. Now click on this link, click on this download link, click on this download link. As you can see, the download has started. So I'll quickly open the Explorer. So in the meanwhile, I will pause the video. Once it is downloaded, then we'll resume. Welcome back, guys. Now as we can see, the package has been downloaded, so double click on it. So let's just minimize this window. Now we need to click on this Eclipse ID for Java developers, and we need to simply click on this install button, and as you can see, the installation folder will be this. So click on this install, accept now. So the installation is in progress. Now click on this accept. So guys, installation has been complete. So I'll click on this Explorer link, and as you can see, we need to click on this .exe file. So please note, when you will watch the video, there may be different versions are available. So this is the Photon version. So there may be different versions, but you don't need to worry about that. You just need to check the compatibility. Unless and until you download the beta version, it will all work. So guys, this is the workspace which we are going to define. So I'll browse and I'll save this to the different folder, so that whenever we format our PC, so in most of the cases, the data which we save in the C drive, which might get lost, so please put this workspace in some other directory. Okay, so I'm selecting this D drive workspace. Okay, and I'll simply click on the launch button. So this is the latest Eclipse. So now I'll maximize the window and I'll cancel out this welcome tab. Okay. So guys, we'll straight away jump into the Maven project. So I'll click on file, new, and please note, we'll not create the Java project. We will be creating the Maven. So click on this other, then simply open this Maven folder. And as you can see, there is a link for Maven project. So select and click on next. So again, we'll click on next, next. Okay, so this group ID is nothing but the package name. So we'll enter our package name as com.testingadvices. Artifact ID is nothing but the folder. So we'll name our project as Maven Cucumber. And in order to reduce the complexity, I'll simply cancel out this Maven Cucumber from the package. And yes, we are done. So click on this finish. And as you can see, the project is created. So I'll click on this pom.xml file overview tab. So as you can see, group artifact ID, which is nothing but Maven Cucumber. This is our project name. Then the group ID com.testingadvices, which is nothing but the package inside this source main Java and source test Java folder. If you open that, you can see this package. And you can further see this default Java file, which comes with the package. So guys, you can see in the console, there are two warnings shown over here. One is regarding the JRE which we have installed, so we need to correct the path. Then the second is about the library. We need to specify the path for the library and the JRE version. So let's resolve this. So please provide the attention and perform the steps as I do, or else you will get errors in later part of the course. So first we need to browse to this window, preference, then May 1, and within this May 1 we need to click on this installations. We need to click on this add. So now we need to align this May 1 project with the Eclipse. So click on this directory, go to C, program files, Apache May 1. Yes, and simply select the folder as you can see. Now click on this finish, select this, apply, apply and close. Okay, now again we'll go to window, preference, this time Java, install JRE. We need to click on this add, standard VM, next, JRE home, click on this directory, go to C, program files, Java, select this JDK path. Okay, so in this default, so as you can see, the JRE name is already in use. Okay, so I'll click on this cancel. So as you can see, my JDK has already been selected. If not, then you need to perform the steps I have shown. So I simply edit this field. So you need to pass on that JDK path. Okay, and in this default VM arguments, you need to paste this line of codes. Okay, and simply click on this finish. Okay, apply, apply and close. Now left click on the project, properties, Java build path, libraries, select the JRE that is shown as 1.5, edit, click on alternate JRE. And you can see the JDK 1.8 has been auto-populated. Click on this finish, apply, apply and close. You can see the warning is gone. Okay, so now left click on this project, run as, and click on this Maven install. The required jars is getting downloaded. And here, now you can see the build success message has been shown. If there is anything wrong, then build failure message will be displayed and the errors will be shown. So till now, we have done installation of Eclipse and the associated settings which are required in order to resolve the warnings. Now one more change that we need to do is, okay guys, so within this pom.xml there are many tags, so slowly and gradually we will learn about that, but just to give you a hint, I'll simply copy this URL and I'll open the browser, I'll put to browser, then visit the link. So as you can see, when we visit the link, there are different dependencies listed over here. So for example, when we talk about this Selenium Java, so the version mentioned here is 3.11. so if I click on this Selenium Java, so this is the 3.11, and now we also have this latest version. So if I want to use this dependency, I'll simply paste this code over here and the latest dependency will work. Or you can also update the version, save the file and just make sure you update the latest version. So go to May 1, update project, force update. Okay, so you can see again the latest version will be saved, and if there is any issues, then please check the compatibility of this particular version. So similarly, the files which we have in this pom.xml, update the latest version for all the dependencies. Okay, so I'll see you guys in my next video where we'll look into test ng setup. Thanks for watching the video.